Supreme Media. This virtual full court reference is being conducted to mourn the sad demise of Honorable Mr. Justice Mohan M. Shantanagowdar, Judge Supreme Court of India, who left for the heavenly abode at the age of 62 years on 24th of April 2021 at New Delhi. Honorable Mr. Justice Shantanagowdar is survived by Madam Srimati Sunita Shantanagowdar, son Sri Shuprasad Shantanagowdar, and daughter Pooja Shantanagowdar. His lordship was born in Chikkerur village, Irekerur taluk of Haveri district on May 5th, 1958 to Mallikarjun Gowda and Srimati Indira. His father was an advocate in Dharwad and was a part-time teacher at University College of Law in Dharwad. Mallikarjun Gowda's command over the court fee and a suit valuation act was so remarkable that many students from colleges attended his classes. Honorable Mr. Justice Shantanagowda enrolled with the State Bar Council on 5-9-1980 and joined the chambers of Sri I.G. Hiregowda, the legendary advocate of Dharwad, whose office was akin to a law university. Honorable Mr. Justice Shantanagowda soon thereafter shifted to Bangalore to join the chambers of advocate Shivraj Patil, as he then was, who later adorned the bench of the Supreme Court of India. He set up his independent practice in 1984. In 1991, he was elected to the State Bar Council and remained vice chairman from 1991 to 1993, and then the chairman in 95 to 96. His lordship served as state public prosecutor of Karnataka state from 1999 to 2002 before being appointed as an additional judge on May 12, 2003 and as permanent judge on September 24, 2004. Honorable Mr. Justice Shantanagowda served as the president of the Bangalore Mediation Center from 2015 to 2016. He was also the guardian judge of the Karnataka State Legal Service Authority. His lordship was later transferred to the Kerala High Court, where he assumed charge as the acting Chief Justice on August 1, 2016. Justice Shantanagowda was sworn in as the Chief Justice of Kerala High Court on September 22, 2016 and remained as such till his elevation to the Honorable Supreme Court of India on February 17, 2017. His Lordship had a term till May 5, 2023 in the Honorable Supreme Court of India. Honorable Mr. Justice Shantanagowda's robust application of common sense, clubbed with his experience as a practicing lawyer, helped him swiftly clasp with crux of the cases. The empathy within him was such that he unendingly encouraged junior advocates to argue their cases to the fullest of their heart's content. His lordship never formed an opinion until he heard both sides thoroughly. Mr. Justice Shantanagowda's persona was synonymous with simplicity. It came very innately to him and not as an imbibed virtue. His effortless simplicity never came in the way of taking fearless decisions. He passed a dissenting judgment in the Indoor Development Authority case. In his historic judgment of February 2020 in Sakkubayi versus State of Karnataka, the apex court ordered for the demolition of all illegal structures in Hampi that were constructed in violation of law. This judgment paved the way for the protection of the historic heritage of Hampi from the onslaught of mushrooming illegal structures. He authored the judgment in the case of M. Ravindran versus Intelligence Officer, which reaffirms the often degraded and indefensible right of an accused to be released on default bail. Honorable Mr. Justice Shantanagowda was also a member of the Governing Council of Himachal Pradesh National Law University. Honorable Mr. Justice Shantanagowda was a distinguished judge who had a profound knowledge of all branches of law. He was a highly self-disciplined, intelligent, and hard-working person. His Lordship was also my personal friend. I shared the bench with His Lordship at Karnataka High Court and benefited immensely from the amazing legal acumen. His Lordship was very cool and kind-hearted gentleman, having vast knowledge of law in every field. With the passing away of the Honorable Mr. Justice Mohan M. Shantanagowda, we have lost a fine gentleman, a great human being, a great jurist, and a great personality. It is not only a loss to the bereaved family members, but also to the entire legal fraternity. On behalf of the High Court, my brother judges, sister judge, and on my own behalf, I offer my heartfelt condolences to the bereaved family and pray to Almighty to grant eternal peace to the departed soul in the heavenly abode. Jai Hind.
I request Sri Ashok Sharma, Learned Advocate General, to please address.
My Lord Honorable the Chief Justice, Mr. Lingappa Narayana Swami, Honorable Mr. Justice R. Malimar, Honorable Mr. Justice Trilok Singh Chauhan, Honorable Mr. Justice Sureshwar Singh Thakur, Honorable Mr. Justice Vivek Singh Thakur, Honorable Mr. Justice Ajay Mohan Goyal, Honorable Mr. Justice Sandeep Sharma, Honorable Mr. Justice Chandra Bhushan Barawalia, Honorable Mr. Justice Anoop Chitkara, Honorable Ms. Justice Josna Rival Dua, Sri Ramakant Sharma, Learned Chairman, Bar Council of Himachal Pradesh, Sri Nareshwar Singh Chandel, Learned President, HP High Court Bar Association, Sri Balram Sharma, Learned Assistant Solicitor General of India, Honorable Retired Judges, Learned Members of the Bar, Registrars and Registrar General, Distinguished Guests, Officers and Officials of the Registry, Officials from the Electronic and Print Media, Ladies and Gentlemen. Today we have assembled here to mourn the sad and untimely demise of late Honorable Mr. Justice Mohan Shantanagowda, former Judge of Honorable Supreme Court of India, who breathed his last at the age of about 62 years on 25th of April 2021. Late Mr. Justice Shantanagowda was 9th Serial Most Judge of the Supreme Court. In due course of time, His Lordship would have demitted the office on 4th May 2023. Late Justice Shantanagowda was born on 5th May 1958 and was enrolled as an advocate in 1980. After a brief spell of practice in Dharwad, His Lordship joined the chamber of Sri Shivraj Patil, advocate as he then was, and who later on was elevated as Judge of the Honorable Supreme Court of India. Justice Shantanagowda specialized in civil, criminal, and constitutional matters. Among other offices, Justice Shantanagowda had served as Vice Chairman of Karnataka State Bar Council from 1991 to 1993 and as Chairman of Karnataka State Bar Council in the year 1995 and 1996. His Lordship served as State Public Prosecutor of Karnataka State from 1999 to 2002. He was appointed Permanent Judge of Karnataka High Court in September 2004. His Lordship was appointed Chief Justice of Kerala High Court in 2016 and was elevated to the Supreme Court on February 17, 2017, and was scheduled to retire on May 4, 2023. Justice Shantanagowda was known as judge who spoke his mind. He never missed words, both in his judgments nor his public addresses. His Lordship came into public attention in the Supreme Court when His Lordship refused to agree with the majority opinion rendered by Justice Arun Mishra on the bench in one land acquisition case. Justice Santhanagowda reasoned that a contrary opinion has already been rendered by a coordinate bench on the issue. Hence, the question should be referred to the larger bench for final and authoritative pronouncement. The controversy was settled, and then the Chief Justice Deepak Mishra referred the case to the constitutional bench. His lordship was equally vocal outside the courtroom. Justice Santhanagowda told an assembly of law students in Kochi that it was time to speak against acts of spreading misinformation by Gautri among the poor and vulnerable. My lord highlighted the role played by the mass communication technology in this phenomenon. A series of recent judgments and orders in the Honorable Supreme Court bear ample testimony to Justice Santhanagowda's pronouncement for personal liberty. In one of his judgments, his lordship held that an accused had an indefeasible right to bail if the probe agency failed to complete the investigation within the statutory period. A bench of which Justice Santhanagowda was part of had expressed its anguish on police brutalities. It had called for the democratic policing by observing that those who are called upon to administer the criminal law must bear in mind that they have a duty not merely to the individuals accused before them, but also to the state and to the community at large. In one of his last judgments, the Honorable Judge sought to protect the poor man's earning by making the locker system in banks more accountable, especially in light of the high-tech bank thefts. Justice Santhanagowda had said that bank could not wash their hands off any liability if any harm was caused to their customers' lockers or safe deposits in an era when miscreants could manipulate technology to gain access to electronically operated bank lockers. The judgment had given the Reserve Bank of India 6 months to lay down the comprehensive directions mandating the steps to be taken by the banks with respect to locker facility, safe deposit facility management. Another stance that Justice Santhanagowda did not shy from taking on big companies was his judgment, which came as a shock for online platforms like Google. A bench of which he was part of had held that the internet intermediaries could not be protected from criminal defamation cases registered against them prior to October 27, 2009. It was only on October 27, 2009 that the Parliament finally moved in and amended the Information Technology Act 2000 to protect the online intermediaries from liability for criminal defamatory content published in them by their third parties. The lawsuit was also part of verdict which brought deemed universities under the Prevention of Corruption Act. Justice Santhanagowda was one of the 9 judges on the bench which was formed by the former CGI to examine the larger questions of faith, religious freedom, and essential religious practices. The hearing of the case, however, never took off. In the death of Honorable Mr. Justice Santhanagowda, we have lost a legal luminary, a thorough gentleman, and in his death, it is not his family only which has lost, but it is the legal fraternity as a whole and humanity as a whole which has lost. The void created by his untimely death is difficult to fill. On behalf of the state of Himachal Pradesh, on behalf of my colleagues, and on my own behalf, I convey my heartfelt condolences to the members of the bereaved family and pray to the Almighty to grant eternal peace to the departed soul in the heavenly abode. Jai Hind.
Now I request Sri Ramakrishna, Learned Chairman, Bar Council, Himachal Pradesh, to please address.
My Lord Honorable the Chief Justice and his companion judges, Learned Advocate General, Learned President of the High Court Bar Association, Learned Assistant Solicitor General of India, Learned members of the Bar Council of Himachal Pradesh, Learned senior advocates, my colleagues at the bar, Learned registrars and staff of the High Court, ladies and gentlemen. Today we have assembled through virtual mode to mourn the sad and sudden demise of Honorable Justice Mohan M. Santhanagowda, sitting judge of the Supreme Court of India, who breathed his last on 25th April 2021. And to pay our humble tribute and homage to the departed soul. Sir Walter Scott, has immortalized the reality of human life by his famous lines, I quote, "And come he slow, or come he fast, it is but death who comes at last," I unquote. This is the destiny of every person born on earth. Honorable Justice Mohan M. Santana Godar was born on 5th May 1958, and after obtaining the degree of law, got himself enrolled as an advocate on 5th September 1980. Justice Santana Godar practiced for 1 year at Dharwad in the chambers of Sri I.G. Hire Godar, advocate, and thereafter shifted his practice to Bengaluru, where he joined the chambers of Sri Shivraj V. Patil, advocate, as he then was, who later adorned the chair of the Supreme Court of India. He practiced mainly in civil, criminal, and writ matters. Honorable Justice Mohan M. Santana Godar remained vice chairman of the State Karnataka Bar Council from 1991 to 1993, and thereafter as chairman in the years 1995 and 96. He served as the State Public Prosecutor of Karnataka State from 1999 to 2002. Honorable Justice Santana Godar was appointed as additional judge of Karnataka High Court on 12th May 2003 and as permanent judge on 24th September 2004. He also remained the president of Bangalore Mediation Center. Honorable Justice Mohan M. Santana Godar was appointed as the acting Chief Justice of Kerala High Court on 1st August 2016. And thereafter as Chief Justice on 22nd September 2016. Honorable Justice Mohan M. Santana Godar was elevated as Judge of the Supreme Court of India on 17th February 2017. A fairly long career in the legal and judicial field gave a very wide experience to Justice Santana Godar. He was a refined judge whose knowledge is reflected in the various notable judgments given by him, and he has left his mark through these judgments that he delivered during his tenure at the Supreme Court of India. Cruel hands of destiny have snatched one of the most intelligent judges of the Supreme Court of India, who was to retire on 5th May 2023. With his death, we have lost a great human being, a legal luminary, and a great judge. The void created by his death is difficult to be filled. This is an irreparable loss to the family of Honorable Justice Mohan M. Santana Godar. In this moment of grief, I, on my behalf, as well as on behalf of the entire legal fraternity of the state of Himachal Pradesh, offer our heartfelt condolences to the bereaved family. May the Almighty God give them courage to bear this irreparable loss, and may the noble soul rest in eternal peace. Thank you.
I request Sri Nareshwar Singh Chandel, Learned President, High Court Bar Association, to please address.
My Lord Honorable Chief Justice Lingarappa Narayan Swami, Honorable Mr. Justice Ravi Manimat, Honorable Mr. Justice Talok Singh Chauhan, Honorable Mr. Justice Sureshwar Singh Thakur, Honorable Mr. Justice Vivek Singh Thakur, Honorable Mr. Justice Ajay Mohan Goyal, Advocate General Himachal Pradesh, Shri Ramakant Sharma.
Missing.
Government of India, respected members of the Bar, Registrar Generals, Registry of Honorable High Court. Today, we all have assembled today to pay homage to a great soul, Justice Mohan Mallikarjun Gogat Shantanu Gogat, Justice Supreme Court of India, who left for heavenly abode on 24th April 2021. Justice Mohan Shantanu Gogat was born in District Harihar, Karnataka on 5th May 1958. His Lordship Father Mallikarjun Gogat was practicing advocate in Dharwad District. Justice Mohan, after completing his LLB, enrolled himself with the Bar Council of Karnataka and started practicing at Dharwad and later on shifted to Bangalore. In the year 1991, His Lordship was elevated as a member Bar Council of Karnataka and was elected as Vice Chairman Karnataka Bar Council from 1991 to 1993. And later on became the chairman from 1995 to 1996. His Lordship was served also served as a state public prosecutor from 1991 to 2002. On 12th May 2003, His Lordship was appointed as additional judge of Karnataka High Court and was appointed as a permanent judge on 24th September 2009. His Lordship was later on transferred to Kerala High Court, where he assumed charge as an acting Chief Justice on 1st August 2016. Justice Mohan was sworn in as a Chief Justice of Karnataka High Court on 2nd September 2016, and on 17th February 2017, he was elevated as Judge of Honorable Supreme Court of India. During his tenure as Judge of Honorable Supreme Court, Karnataka High Court, Kerala High Court, His Lordship has delivered many landmark judgments. I, on my behalf and on behalf of Himachal Pradesh High Court Bar Association, express our sincere condolences to all the family members of His Lordship Justice Mohan. May his soul rest in peace. Jai Hind.
Now I request Sri Balram Sharma, Learned Assistant Solicitor General of India, to please address.
My Lord, the Honorable Chief Justice, Honorable Judges, Honorable Former Judges, Learned Advocate General, Chairman Bar Council, President of the Bar Association, Secretary and other office bearers of the Bar Association, Standing Council for the Government of India and the Government of Himachal Pradesh, my colleagues at the Bar, ladies and gentlemen. With deep sense of sorrow, we have assembled here today to pay homage to the departed soul of Honorable Mr. Justice Mohan M. Shant Nagodar, who died suddenly on 25th April 2021 at Gurugram. He was 62. His Lordship was elevated as Judge of the Honorable Supreme Court on 17th February 2017, and his tenure was till May 5, 2023. He was born on 5th May 1958 in Karnataka. He enrolled himself as an advocate on 5th September 1980. His Lordship served as Vice Chairman, Chairperson of Karnataka Bar Council from 1991 to 1993, and as a Chairperson of Karnataka State Bar Council during 1995 and 1996. He also served as State Public Prosecutor of Karnataka State from 1999 to 2002. His Lordship was the Chief Justice of the Honorable High Court of Kerala before being elevated to the Honorable Supreme Court. His Lordship was a distinguished judge and had vast knowledge of law. He has left the huge legacy in the form of his judgment. His Lordship strongly advocated for the preservation of the rich diversity of our country and underlined the need to promote inclusiveness and empathy and fight bigotry and hatred. His Lordship was also an advocate of rationality and critical thinking. His Lordship was adept at delivering the judgment, which is why many important questions of the law were dealt with. His Lordship made his own mark through several notable decisions made during his tenure in the Honorable Supreme Court. His Lordship holds that it is the duty of magistrate to inform an accused of their right to obtain default bail, which is important for the concern shown for his personal freedom and what he wants to achieve. His Lordship also ruled that court should not punish an accused if he has no legal representation. His Lordship's decision in Taj Mahal Hotel versus United India Insurance Company Limited reflects his tendency to adopt a constitutional interpretation that would favor a person who stands against a large and powerful institution. A similar approach was evident in the case of Farmer against the Seed Company. Series of his landmark judgment authored by him cannot be described in a short span of time, except to say that he always guarded right and personal liberty of the citizen. He was a very warm and affectionate individual. His death is a great loss to the country, entire legal fraternity, and to the many lives he touched with compassion. I, on my behalf and on behalf of my colleagues who are standing counsel and counsel for the central government and esteemed member of the bar, pray to the Almighty God to give enough strength and courage to the bereaved family to bear this irreparable loss. May I request the Honorable Chief Justice to convey our condolences and feeling to the bereaved family. Thank you.
I request my Lord Honorable Chief Justice to announce 2 minutes silence as a mark of respect to the departed soul. I seek permission of my Lord Honorable the Chief Justice to close the proceedings. Proceedings are closed.